from the very beginning, being a disciple has always involved making disciples. I mean, even Jesus' initial words, which we talked about in the last lesson, follow me, he follows up and says, follow me and I will make you fishers of men. That was built in from the beginning. And so we get to the end of Matthew, for example, where this lesson is focused. And now he's saying, now, I've died on the cross, risen from the grave, I'm about to ascend into heaven, so you go and you make disciples. And so, obviously, we've talked about disciple-making all throughout this, but this is, I think, a good time to pause and want to ask you and then to think through with this person or people you're discipling, like, is this really happening? Has this become just a Bible study, or are you really making disciples who are starting to make disciples? And so, and if not, so think about the people you're discipling. Have they started to walk through this with somebody else? Is, if not, is there a plan for them to do that very soon? I mean, we're getting near the end of this kind of journey with that person, and that is intended to be multiplied in others' lives. If it hasn't already started multiplying, we just got to make sure to keep that emphasis there. Otherwise, we won't do it.
Yeah, and I know we've said this over and over again, but I got to just say it again, because we tend to just want to do our own thing, and disciple making is hard. Mm. And I know we emphasized from the start, this is not for you to read on your own, but I guarantee there are a lot of people who are just going to read this on their own. And just understand, that was not the intention. Like, I was almost like, I'm not even gonna do that if that's what's gonna happen. Yeah. We have enough of that going on. This is meant to be passed on. The knowledge is meant to be passed on. We're teaching you to be a teacher. And so again, if you are just reading this for yourself and not passing it on, just understand you're going against the whole point of this thing. And this is, we're trying to equip you for this Great Commission.
Yeah, and not only going against the whole point of this thing, but you're missing out.
This
is the joy of pouring your life and pouring the gospel and the word of God into other people, leading other people to be followers of Christ. Yes. This is what we're created for. This is what we've got breath for. This is why the Lord hasn't just saved us and taken us straight up to heaven. He's left us here for a reason. We get to be a part of the spread of this. And so we don't want to miss out on this. There's joy to be found in making disciples. And so not just because, okay, this is the command, now go do it.
Yeah.
But this is the command, and this is a command that brings life.
It's purpose. It gives us purpose. Yeah, like, absolutely. There's a reason why I'm alive today. Mm-hmm. Like, and it's not just for me to just sit around and enjoy myself or whatever. Yeah. And sometimes that may sound more appealing as just to do my own thing, but to be living on a mission and to fulfill the mission that God's called you to, that's a rush. Yeah. That's a purpose. The people that get depressed are often the people that are just looking at themselves and just too much focus on themselves rather than realizing, man, God made me for a purpose. And as we fulfill that purpose, we find fulfillment.
And there's so much we could talk about here. There's a spectator mentality is just killing the church in so many ways. Like, nobody's intended to be on the sidelines on this thing, but every single follower of Christ, every single disciple making disciples in the context of where they live and work and play and where God has put them, saying, who can I lead to become a follower of Christ, to grow in their relationship with Christ? That's what I'm going to spend my life for as I look at my family, my job, my neighborhood, whatever it might be. And so keep that focus. If there's not already intentional plan in place for that happening in the lives of the people that you are discipling, then now is the time to make sure that plan is in place.